Right, Aki Kareem for British Boxers. We're over here at Salford City Boxing Academy today to catch up with unbeaten Savannah Marshall. Let's do it.
Savannah, good spar there, in there with another Olympian, Virginia
Singh. Yeah, it was good.
Really two Olympians sparring.
Yeah, in Earlham.
In
Earlham.
How did you find it?
It was good, it was really good. He was obviously holding back a bit, but you can tell that he's a puncher.
Yeah.
Obviously it was really good.
He's one of those that he doesn't look like he's a traditional boxer, but he can really bang.
Yeah, he can.
Really. But I noticed that you weren't holding back, you were throwing some good shots in there and caught him with a few good ones as well.
I think he must have just switched off for that second.
Do you prefer sparring men or sparring women?
I prefer sparring men.
Mm.
Because you'll never come across a woman that can punch like a man. Never. Also, the skill set's a lot higher and the speed. The only thing that lets it down is the pace, I think, because men do threes, women do twos, so women are a bit more erratic, trying to get the, you know, because twos is more about like speed and work rate, whereas the threes, you can like mooch about and pick your shots a lot more.
Mm. Talking of female boxing, did you watch Katie Taylor's big fight out in America against Pursue?
I haven't seen it yet. I'm saving it.
Yeah.
I'm saving it till I've got like a night, like a couple of hours, and I'm gonna proper analyse it. But I've seen little clips and stuff, and Delphine didn't stop, did she?
Did not stop.
Relentless. Mm. Absolutely relentless. But if I, do you know, from knowing Katie from the amateurs, she'll want to jump straight back in there and prove everyone wrong.
Yeah, there's a lot of people saying she didn't win the fight. There are people coming out now saying actually when they've watched it back, maybe the cleaner work was Katie's, but I think the general consensus was they thought Pursue had won it just on the pressure and the relentlessness.
Yeah. She roughed her up a bit, didn't she? Well, there's clips I've seen, she was just roughing her up and throwing her about, but obviously you don't win on that.
True. Big shock, Anthony Joshua against Andy Ruiz Jr. Did you watch the fight? Or?
Yeah. He didn't look right from the start. He didn't look right at all. Even when he was like coming out, when they were announcing him, just looked like he didn't want to be there.
Were you shocked with the outcome?
No, because I did see a little bit on Andy before the fight, and he had fast hands, and he's not stupid. And one thing I did like, he got given the opportunity and he's just grabbed it with both hands. Whereas you've seen people, you know, in the past who've boxed Joshua and they've just thought, oh, I'm not going to win anywhere. Whereas he...
Eric Molina springs to mind,
yeah,
someone like that.
Yeah.
Even Charles Martin springs to mind, to be honest.
Exactly. And everyone had him down for getting beat, getting knocked out, and he proved everyone wrong.
Big shock.
Yeah.
Opens up the division though, and of course your stablemate Yui probably looking at that thinking, wow, anything can happen in this division.
Yeah. It's everyone's chance now, isn't it?
Yeah. Mm. Another fight. I know you're sort of good with your predictions, so I'm going to ask you about this one. It's well, I think you are. Warrington Galahad.
Do you know, I think... Hi, see you later. I think Galahad might kill him.
What, sorry?
Galahad might stop him.
Oh right, he might KO him, right, okay, yeah.
Only on the fact that Galahad's style is like picking off when they're rushing in and throwing loads of shots. The only thing that let him down, I don't think Galahad's been as active as... what's it called? He hasn't been as active, but... Do you know, if it goes to points, I think Warrant will get it.
Okay.
But I do think... Galahad might stop him, because he can whack.
So if I was going to say to you, what's the one prediction you're going to go with Galahad
knockout? Yeah.
Fair enough.
I think he'll catch him coming in.
Interesting. Another one I want to ask you about, I'm putting you on the spot here a bit, but Nathan Gorman, Daniel Dubois.
I'm going to go Nathan Gorman.
Yeah? Talk me through it.
I just think Nathan's got a higher skill set than Dubois. Dubois can whack, but I think Nathan's got a higher skill set and he's, you know, a lot better casting than anyone Dubois fought already.
Fair enough. Short and sweet, that one.
Yeah.
Bit like your last fight.
Yeah.
Victoria Ware, Channel 5.
She was a tough year though, wasn't she?
I sense a little bit of
sarcasm.
She come to win. See you later, Jonathan. I sense a little bit of sarcasm in your voice there.
Yeah, I was a little bit disappointed with the opponent, but people have got to understand it's nothing to do with me. I can only fight what's put in front of me. Do you know, and if it's a sack of potatoes, it's a sack of potatoes.
Yeah, I mean, that's one thing. I know you, and if it's up to you, you'd be fighting these big fights all the time, wouldn't you? But there's a lot of politics that goes behind getting these big fights sorted, isn't there, as well? And I know
See you later.
I know you and Peter are really keen to get these big fights on, but sometimes it's just a matter of time, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, well, to be fair, that was a bit disrespectful, but because she was durable. She'd never been stopped in, I think, something like 7 years. She'd boxed Hannah Rank and Stacey Copeland, went the distance, and when I did watch her back, I thought, you know what, she knows what she's doing. She knows she's a journeywoman and she knows how to survive. And I was surprised that I got her out that quick. I was really surprised. Because like I said, when I watched her, when people were laying on her, she was tucking up, she was grabbing hold, she was doing all the things she was meant to do. Like I said, if you get hit with that body shot, it's one thing
that
you can't train for.
Well, every time I speak to your trainer, Peter Fury, he's always complimentary about your punch power, but he also talks about the way you set shots up. So, you know, it seems to me like since from the very first time I saw you fight to now, it's becoming more effortless for you. You're placing the shots a lot better.
Oh yeah, I call Peter me guru. He's like got all this life advice, and in the ring the way he explains things, like sometimes I think, oh yeah, Peter, that's not going to work. But then when you actually do it and it comes off, you think, God, he was right. But
The Oracle,
yeah. The guru.
Well, every time we put a video of Peter up, he instantly gets loads of people watching it, because I think people are very interested in what he's got to say, and he's been around the game and got a lot of wisdom, and of course he has trained someone to the heavyweight world title as well.
Yeah, he's very wise, a very wise man. And he thinks of things that you'd never ever think of. Like even, like, body language. Sometimes I'll come in and say, how are you feeling? When he knows already that I feel like crap. But he's a very wise man.
Good man to have in your corner.
Exactly.
And obviously you're hoping that he's gonna lead you, and you're gonna lead yourself all the way to a world title.
Hopefully, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I've noticed that your fan base continues to grow. It's not just women though. You've actually got a lot of male fans, and I don't mean just like in a weird way, but actually a lot of male fans who rate you as a boxer.
Yeah. It's nice to see, because you know, sometimes, you know, well, I've came to spar before, and men will say, "Oh, I'm not getting in with her," or "I'm not going to hit a woman." And like now, it's just like, "Oh, so fans come to spar," type thing. So yeah. You're starting to get recognised as a boxer, and not, "Oh, that female's coming." Type thing.
Well, that must be a feather in your cap, you know, because that's a big stage to get over, a big hurdle, isn't it, to get over in the boxing world, really, that gender thing.
Yeah, it wasn't so much as an amateur, but since I've turned pro, it's a bit, you know, female professional boxing is still a bit raw to many people.
And we've got to give a shout out to Gary Booth here, you know, training down here at Salford City Boxing Academy. He's a mad character.
He is.
But it's a great gym to come down and train in. And I know you're based in Earlham now as well, aren't you?
Yeah. He went away last week, and the gym wasn't the same. The tunes were rubbish.
You what?
It was all grimy. Ben had grime on all week. I was like, oof.
Not your thing,
no. I'm a bit of a hater.
Oh, you're a grime hater, but you like Gary's techno and random shizzle.
I like the house. Get to pumping.
Yeah. Well, it's always good to see you. And we're going to be following you, obviously, especially now you're in Earlham, sorry, we're going to be seeing you a lot more as the progress goes, and looking forward to your next fight announcement.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, leave your comments below. We love hearing your opinion, and also remember to hit that subscribe button. See you next time.